Hello my dear students, I am Priyanka from Sandpoint Classes Belgaum. So today I am here to share a very good news for you people, especially for the civil engineering graduates. That is, you have got much awaited PWD notification today itself. So today's date is 30th July 2020. Okay, so whatever the syllabus I had told you for HK notification, the same syllabus is there for this, because this exam is conducted by KPSC. Last year even we had trained the students for PWD also, where the exam was conducted by KEA, okay, and the syllabus was different. But now they have retained the standard syllabus only, so no worries about that, because last time when there was the PWD notification, there was much more worries for the students because many new subjects were added. So ee hangenilla, it is very normal KPSC syllabus. So if you have already studied for this these subjects whichever are mentioned, that is really good for you people. And if you haven't prepared, that is for fresh graduates, study the subjects, and I will be making a separate video for the syllabus. Okay, so now I'll be telling you the vacancies there. So in the last time, last April in 2019, the vacancies were called for AE as well as for JE. AE was 500, JE was 350, altogether it was 850. But this time they have called 990 vacancies. So in that, for AE it is 600 plus 60. So 600 is for non-HK, 60 is for HK. So this time in this PWD, they have given the special reserved 60 seats for AE, for HK also. So now the HK people, you people are very lucky, because just last month itself you have got 181 vacancies for irrigation plus this. So just for six districts, these vacancies are many in fact, okay. And the eligibility for this AE is BE Civil and BE CTM also, and the salary for this is 43,100 to 83,900. And when it comes for JE, it is 325 for non-HK vacancies, and for HK it is 5 vacancies for JE. So, and the salary for JE is 33,450 to 62,600. So what is the age limit for these two vacancies when you are filling the form? So your age should be maximum 35 years old for general merit. And if you are from 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B, 3 years relaxation is given for you, that is till 38 years. And for category 1 and SEST, it is 40 years old. Okay, so bhala jana wait madakattidre yakandra there was very big confusion for the students who had attended previous PWD exam. This 1 year was very much confusion for us as well as for students, because they used to ask us, ma'am, yen akaitri idu, whether they will conduct re-exam or whether they will continue with the previous vacancy only. But everyone have got answer today, that is re-exam will be conducted. Okay, so prepare for this exam. And now, do you know like when the application date is starting? Just 17 days after, that is on August 17th, the application will start. 17 to 18 days from today. Okay, and the last date for filling the form, they have given 1 month, for 1 month time for you, that is 16th September 2020. So by then, you should, the application will be closed, and the fee payment is till you can do for 18th September 2020, that is 2 days extension they have given you for making the fee payment. Okay, and the students, see, the one who are BE graduates, you are eligible to apply for AE as well as for JE. Your college going students irtarala, like the one who have completed diploma and either they are in second year, third year or final year engineering, so they are eligible for JE. So our yav exam baritaru, they will write JE paper. But ee engineering adavaru yavad baribodu, they can write both AE and JE. So you can write two paper also, but for that you have to fill two different application form, because exam date will also be different, like 1 day before after. First mostly will be JE, next day it will be AE. So you can write both the papers now. So if a candidate is BE graduate, he is eligible for 990 vacancies, so which is very good number of vacancies for you people. Okay, and here I am mentioning the contact numbers, so when you are filling the form or if you have any clarifications, you can contact those numbers which are mentioned. See, when I make a YouTube video, the students will contact me assuming that I am from KPSC. See, I am just a person who share the information to the student in the most convenient way. So I don't belong to any official. So if you have any doubts in like I have some errors I have filled when I was filling the form and also, you have to contact the concerned authority, not me. Okay na? And what is the fee for filling the form? It is 600 rupees for general merit, and for 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B it is 300 rupees, and for ex-military serviceman it is 50 rupees, and for category 1 SC ST there is no fee. So whatever I am saying now, it is almost the same as that what I informed in my previous HK notification video also. You can check that. Everything is same now because it is conducted again by KPSC only. Okay, but as I told you, like SC ST and category 1, zero is the fee. That is, you don't need to pay the fee. But for everyone, you have to pay 35 rupees as the processing fee. Okay, so if you consider general merit, you have to pay 600 plus 35, that is 635 rupees you have to pay as the application fee. Now they have given one more statement in the notification if you have read clearly. For the students who have already appeared for the exam last year in April, so you people need not pay the application fee. You just have to fill the form and you have to pay 35 rupees as the processing fee. So you need not pay the fee again. So this is very important condition. And coming to the eligibility criteria, you have to be Indian and Karnataka. Even if you are not from Karnataka, you can write the Kannada exam. So the students who have written 10th standard either in Kannada medium or first and second language in they have taken as Kannada, no need to write Kannada exam. But if you had taken Kannada as third language, and if you haven't taken Kannada as any of the languages till 10th, you have to write separate Kannada exam, which is for 150 marks, and minimum you have to get 50 marks. Okay, and the syllabus is SSLC Kannada syllabus is there for you people. Okay, but now this 50 mark whatever you are getting, it is not considered for altogether result analysis. It is just an exam to make you eligible to write the exam. So confusion madkobedre. In this video I am making the things very clear, because even after making video in the most simpler way, the students will have doubt. So Kannada exam yari kete, only for the student who have taken third language as Kannada and who haven't studied Kannada at all. Aur ashta Kannada exam baridu ulikidavaru yaru baridilla, and this exam is just for an eligibility. Even if you get out of out in that will not matter, or it will not be considered in the further marks allotment procedure. Tilito. And the next is, here also you are having interview, written test as well as interview. So the interview plus written test is for 100 marks or 100% you can say, and in that 12.5% is given for interview and 87.5% is given for written test. So that is how the marks is getting reduced, and 1:3 ratio they will be calling for the interview. Tilito. It is same general KPSC exam pattern, it is same only. And the exam pattern, general studies paper is for 200 marks and duration is 1.5 hours, and specific paper, that is our civil engineering paper, is for 200 marks and it is for 2 hours, and there is negative marking, how much, 1/4 or 0.25 negative marking is there for you. And again in this notification they haven't clearly mentioned whether the exam will be offline, that is OMR based, or whether it will be online. Okay, like online paper, CBT test, nothing has been mentioned. But once they make the decision ki if it is online, then definitely they will be giving you a mock test. Okay, so students, this is, and the syllabus for this is mentioned here, that is visit kpsc.kar.nic.in/syllabus. So whatever the KPSC syllabus is there, which is being followed since years, the same syllabus is there for you, even for HK students also. So the students who have applied for HK with the same syllabus, you are eligible for rest 990 vacancies also here. So altogether it is very good opportunity for you people. And coming to us, like we have already started classes for HK also. See, just like when the notification happened, within 5 minutes I started getting calls, ma'am, when you are starting with offline class. Okay, because of this corona situation, we cannot start offline classroom as of now. So I don't want to give any false promises. Okay, we may start the day, the very next day when the government issues an order ki all the education institutes can start, then only we can start the offline class. But now we are running classroom teach online classes only, and the syllabus whatever is there in KPSC, we are following the same syllabus and we are making our lectures accordingly, and we are providing pre-recorded video lectures only, so that there will not be any internet issues, as well as the people who are working, they can watch the video lectures there and then only. And along with this, we are providing the workbook, the work booklets for the students, which are having formula, synopsis and MCQs of around 4,000 to 5,000 questions. So once you take the admission, we will be couriering you those books. And apart from this, after some time, we will be providing you even online mock test also. So everything is included in this package. I will not promise you ki from day one only online mock test will happen, because we need some time to make, to choose the questions and to make the online test. And we will be making online test subject wise, okay, as well as later on mixed subject test, which includes technical and general studies both. See, we teach here technical as well as general studies. So the students who have already done KS coaching and all, for you no need to purchase this package for general studies, because you have already studied that. And we have kept the fee pattern different for technical as well as general studies. Okay, so and along with this, like, we conduct even doubt clearing session also. So if you have any doubts, you can ask us the doubts meanwhile. So we will be clearing, and whatever the lectures we are making as per SSC JEE, and even we have taken questions from GATE and IES. That is, we have kept our teaching standards little higher level only, because as we train here students for GATE, so as per our experience in previous PWD classroom teaching, some questions were asked from GATE without change in data. This I keep telling almost in all of my videos as well as for my students. So that is the reason in our video classes, we have taken questions and we have solved the questions, considering that you can expect these kind in your exams. And do not consider that these video recordings are surfacial kind of. So whatever we teach in the class, the same way we have taught it right from the basics, considering that you people might have forgotten the basic concepts, or you are not that much strong in the basic concepts. So we are dealing with right from the basics. So this is what we have taken care. So once again, it is very good news for the students. And one more thing, most important doubt for final year students. See, now some of the autonomous institutes or universities like Rewa University and KLE Tech Hubli, they have completed already engineering, the final year students. Now they can apply for this course comfortably. But the other students who are at in final year, so nimda situation henga agite andre neevu ikadiyu illa akadiyu illa, so you have neither completed engineering nor you are in, because this notification has come in such a position ki you have not completed the engineering. So you see to it that you try talking with the university or your college, because September 16th, or if you consider fee payment, September 18th is the last date. So you should see to it that before that you get degree somehow. So try discussing with the university, with your HOD, with your principal, and try to be practical in this, because we don't know again when this notification has come, will be coming again. So this is very good opportunity. So I don't want you final year students to miss this opportunity in just a blink of an eye. So nimdu miss aadrunu very minute olag miss akkaithe. So try to do something in this way. So I am always there for your support, and if you need any assistance from us, like online test series or video lectures or the books which I am saying which are having MCQs, we will be providing you that. Okay, so again, all the very best for you students. So prepare for this.